Hey guys, how are we doing? G'day, g'day. Thanks for coming along. You wouldn't mind just signing your life away?
Sure.
Just for, for the COVID-19 plan?
Yeah.
It's a sign of the time, guys. Hand sanitizer, all that sort of stuff, you know, right, John?
Just
left
the office.
Here, obviously, around ideas generation, based on conversation, so having a discussion with other people at your table, and then we will be getting up and moving around and exploring. We're going to explore 3 main questions, given the fact that we've only got the hour, that will help drive the communications plan. Really importantly, we want everyone's views, so everyone's opinion matters and everyone's had a voice. Feel really comfortable. Now, whether that's actually a verbal voice or we always got butcher's paper to write. Write down some of your ideas and comments, or for some of us, like Brendan and Megan, who are in the toolbox, he might come up with a suggestion, and he might want to sit there and do a doodle, do a picture, and say, you know, instead of writing down, I think we should help communicate better with the outside workforce by doing a toolbox talk. He might want to do a picture, something that denotes a little bit creative, and we can take that away and feed into the communication plan itself. So each of the tables, we've got 3 tables. We've got designated scribes. We've got 2 designated scribes, or people that are going to just stay at the table. The rest of the teams will move on. And I might ask Nathan if you wouldn't mind to stay at that table. And really, the role of those 3 scribes or table leaders is, I guess, just to keep the conversation on track. We'll come up with questions in a minute, and making sure that there is an opportunity for everyone to. All right, so as I said in the opening remarks, it's going to be 3 rounds or 3 opportunities for you to go and move around and lock down the courts, have the discussion at the table. We're going to add to the butcher's paper, now whether they're words or a diagram or a toolbox or an email or however you sort of want to communicate, but, verbally, visually, or in written style, that's fine. And then we're going to have a group discussion and look at, I guess, patterns and commonality and use as an opportunity to feed into that. All right, so maybe just take a step back, understanding where we're at with the cultural project. So we've obviously got a wonderful job developing our new set of staff values around honesty, teamwork, respected, community focused, motivated and supported. I think we put a lot of time and effort in consultation to come out some really strong and powerful statements. Not only in those words, but I guess in the narratives and the descriptions that fall under those words as well. So so really the next step, as we've discussed previously, is looking at developing a survey and gaining the staff perspectives on how are we actually travelling as an organisation or a staffing body in living up to those values or those organisational behaviours that we hold to be the peer. And then from those, once we roll out the survey, we get the results back, we look for themes and commonality, and we're on a series of focus groups and workshops to say, I think this is a really important and powerful part of the project. Well, if we say that expectations are up here and the staffing body is saying, well, really, we're sort of down here, what are some practical steps we can take to get from here up to there? That's really the action plan for our development process. And I guess it's basically the approach that we're taking on the overall project is based on every guide and three methods around define. We've gone through that process around defining what's really important to us as a staffing body, aligning, so we're building the cultural foundation, the framework. So alignment is through a survey, and then coming up with an action plan, and then managing the input. Today, the goal is to provide input into a comms plan, and communicate with all staff the upcoming cultural survey. So the three questions I thought we could focus on today, and that will be the focus of each day. Is the first one, so raising the project awareness. So before we go out to all the staff with the survey, we said it's coming up saying, here, fill out this survey. What are some of the effective practical communication techniques that we can employ? What's going to work for our workplace? The results of the survey and the associated climate action. So they're the three sort of key questions once you're going to find today. And then one three groups of four or five, which is great. So, that's a good question. We've got the mixture of staff, so I think we've got a pretty good mix of staff for each of the tables. We've got a scribe for each of the tables, so let's go for it. So, table number one here. So, the question that we'll be asking is the first one, so raising project awareness. So, for the first 10 minutes, we'll get you to work on that first question. Table number two. For the first session, if we were looking at during survey periods, how can we maximise our staff participation in the survey? And then table number three over here, communicating the results. How do we effectively communicate the results of the survey and associated plan of actions? Does everyone pretty comfortable with what we're looking to achieve and how we're going to go about it? If there's any questions, ask the prescribers or come and have a chat to me. We'll just work through those up at the same time. All right, put your creative thinking caps on. Yeah. All right, are we happy to wrap it up there, guys? I'm just mindful of time and appointments. All right, so we might get everyone to rotate their clockwise. So guys, so the first step we can move in for the scribes, just to give a quick summary of what's already been said. And if there's anything that the new group wants to add, please add it. But if there's something on there already that you agree with, then put a tick next to it, or just or an asterisk to say yes, we endorse that. So is everyone comfortable with that?
Would it be
a
nice one?
I'm joking. Oh. No, not quite. No,
I'm joking. I don't know what to do. I was only joking when I said we're going that way.
All right, guys, we might just wrap it up, if that's okay.
Even if it's just the next.
All right. Yeah. Make sure we capture it, I don't want to miss it. I'm sure it's a good point. All right. So, guys, I guess, thanks very much for your input. I think that process worked really well. It seemed like the conversation was flowing really freely. And I think what's really important is not only were we just sort of putting ticks against what people have done before, we were adding to it, but there was also, I think, a couple of crosses where it was just something that. In the next session, we'll just unpack that a little bit and explore a little bit further as to where we as a team want to sort of land on that particular point. I can't remember what the actual issue was, but we'll get to that now. So what I might do is I might get Eileen to come on up and just give a quick summary of the three responses or three different rotations.
on raising project awareness. What are some of the effective practical communication techniques? So this is the first step. So we'll get you to put the chair. And then if anyone wants to chime in throughout the process or towards the end, if you want to add anything or provide any narrative, I'm happy to do so.
So our question was, what are some effective practical communication techniques? I think it was fairly okay to say that everyone said that not one technique will suit everybody because we've got such a diverse employment.
So what does the group think about that? Do you think it's a no, as in we don't think we want to progress with that, or do we think it's a nice to have to do it, but as a communication tool, don't rely too heavily on it? That really, from what I was picking up, from when I was listening into the groups, there was a fair bit sort of saying that face-to-face and making sure that the message that is coming across is authentic and is delivered by the right people at the right time. Does anyone else have any other views on that, I guess?
Because we were able to get this on our corporate values, and if you answer the survey, you might contribute to the culture of the organisation.
That's a really good point. Yep. Okay.
I stole that from John.
It doesn't matter.
Well said.
Like I said, between the outside workforce, the gardeners, the plumbers, their viewpoint, and I probably shouldn't bunch them all together, but the viewpoint out there has always been, why should I fill it in? None of them in the office give a damn, we're going to listen.
We might, I'm just mindful of time, so anything else to add to... Anything to add to... Thanks very much. So thanks for, I think that was a really good summary. Thanks very much, Eileen, for leading that group.
Thank you for all great comments.
All right, Sonia. So
Maybe
just go back to whether we want to run paper and electronic.
I think
both.
You'd have to
both?
Yeah.
Okay. That's all right. Yep.
Okay. It's important to...
So the messaging will be we're about results this time. And again, I don't want to speak of what's happened before. Actually having the conversation and say, what does that mean? What's the practical steps that will hopefully mitigate that risk?
Yeah.
Okay.
And just final. Last point.
To keep as part of the messaging. Excellent. Thanks very much, Tony. Very good. See you later, Kira. Change. Yeah. Brown. Blonde.
Oh, 10 years younger, actually.
Green streets. Maroon. Could have been state of origin last night. Right. Thanks for your help.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks, mate. All right, Nathan, hand over to you for the last question, which is around communicating the results.
So making it something that they actually want to open and read.
And engage. Okay, very good. All right, so thank you very much for that, guys. I think that was a really good, Nathan. So it was a really good session this afternoon. I think what was really impressive is that there was some really innovative and good ideas that came out of that. There was a lot of commonality. There was a couple of suggestions that we challenged, and as a group we sort of agreed to a way forward on that. Is there any final comments or any concerns? Is everyone comfortable with the process we've undertaken and the next steps? Okay, so thanks very much for your time today. Next steps are, as we'll take this away,
we'll grip it up into some sort of draft comps plan. We'll flick it back out to each and everyone that's attended today. We'll raise it at the next project team meeting, and then based on the feedback on the draft, we'll pull it together and get it adopted. Hey? Very good. Thanks very much for your time. Appreciate it. Cheers.